हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे विल डिस्कस एमसीक्यूज ऑन कास्टिंग प्रोसेस पार्ट टू, इन विच आई विल कवर द टॉपिक्स टाइप ऑफ मोल्डिंग सैंड, सैंड मोल्डिंग मेथड्स, टाइप ऑफ कोर एंड कोर प्रिंट्स, गेटिंग सिस्टम एंड टाइप ऑफ गेट्स. ऑल दीज एमसीक्यूज विल बी एक्सप्लेन विद द हेल्प ऑफ डायग्राम्स एंड वीडियोज. सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द फर्स्ट एमसीक्यूज. विच ऑफ द फॉलिंग सैंड इज अप्लाइड डायरेक्टली नेक्स्ट टू द सरफेस ऑफ द पैटर्न. सो इन दिस केस एक्चुअली आवर आंसर इज द फेसिंग सैंड, बिकॉज फेसिंग सैंड इज यूज नेक्स्ट टू द पैटर्न फॉर ऑब्टेनिंग क्लीनर एंड स्मूथर कास्टिंग सरफेस. And it come in contact with the molten metal when the mold is poured. So facing sand have a high strength refractoriness, and that's why we are just pouring a facing sand over the pattern. So your answer is B, facing sand. And next question: facing sand used in foundry work comprises of. So naturally, the facing sand used in the foundry work comprises of a silica and clay, because clay act as a binding agent when mixed with the silica sand to provide the high strength, also maintain their shape and other characteristics at a high temperatures, and that's why our answer is B, silica and clay. Our next question: according to their use, which of the following is not a type of molding sand? So if you see in this diagram, I tried to show that loam sand, grain sand and dry sand is a type of molding sand, but wet sand is not a type of molding sand, and that's why our answer is D, wet sand. Our next question: in sand molding, the bottommost part of the flask is called as a drag. So drag is a lower part of a two-part casting flash. Okay, the drag is placed upside down on a board around a pattern of a part to be cast. So you know that cope is the upper part and the drag is the lower part, and that's why our answer is C, drag, because they are asking that the bottommost part. So bottommost part is a drag. Our next question: what is the amount of clay contained in the loam sand? So here the clay content in the loam sand is relatively more than that of a natural sand. Also, the amount of humid content or the level of water too in the loam sand will be differing similarly, and that's why we are saying that the clay content in the loam sand is around 50%, and that's why your answer is C, 50%. Next question: the mold is housed in a. So actually, we know that the mold is housed in a flask actually. Right now, a flask has only sides and no top or a bottom, and form a frame around the mold. The shape of the flask may be a square, or it may be a rectangle, or any convenient shape according to the mold. So that's why our answer is A, flask. Next question: which of the following helps connecting runner and the mold cavity? If you see in this diagram, I have shown the mold cavity and the runner, and they are connected with the help of gates. And that's why our answer is C, gates. So I have shown here the number of gates, right? It may be a one gate or multiple gates also. Next question, what is the general shape of an open riser? So even if you see in this diagram, I shown that the riser having a cylindrical shape, right? Now the top of the cylinder is open, causing the molten metal direct exposure to the atmosphere. Okay, and that's why, or in this case, our answer is C, cylindrical in shape. Our next question is, the purpose of the riser is to. So the riser is used to compensate for a losses due to shrinkage as the casting goes on cooling. So a riser with a cool and solidifying with the slowest compression, usually the thickest and the largest part of the casting. So that's why we can say that the purpose of the riser is to feed the molten metal to the casting in order to compensate for the shrinkage. Okay, next question. Sprue in the casting refers to. So a sprue is a vertical passage through which the liquid material is introduced into a mold, and it is a large diameter channel through which the material entered into the mold. It connects the pouring basin to the runner. We can see in this diagram also. So sprue will connect the pouring basin and the runner. So our answer is sprue in the casting refers to the vertical passage. So your answer is D. Next question. What prevents the liquid metal from entering the gate? So students, we know that the gate basin play a very vital role in stopping the liquid metal flow. The gate basin allows the turbulently flowing liquid metal into the gate. And that's why our answer is that A, gate basin. Our next question, the primary of a sprue in a casting mold is to. So in this case, you can see that if you observe very carefully here, the molten metals from the pouring basin to the gate is shown in this diagram. Means it's very simple that if you observe the diagram very carefully, this is the molten metal. Okay. So we are just pouring it from the basin to the gate. And that's why I can say that the primary of a sprue in the casting mold is to feed the molten metal from pouring basin to the gate. And that's why our answer is C. Our next question. Which of the following is not a type of gate? So I can show that, suppose you can see this is a top gate. Okay, top gate, we know that it is a type of a gate. Second one, I have shown the bottom gate. So bottom gate is also the type of gate. And third one, we have shown the side gate. So we know that all these three are the type of gates, but if you see the middle gate, so among the given type of, the middle gate is not a type of gate. So in this way, the gates are classified into top, bottom, and the side gate only. And that's why our answer is D, middle gate. Because in the question, they are asked not a type of a. Next question. When hole or a recess is to be produced in the casting, either below or above the parting line, then. Now, if you see in this diagram, this is the core. And this core is just shown that below the parting line. This is your parting line. Okay. Even we can make the hole above the parting line. Means above or below. See, above or below of the parting line. So in such cases, the core which you are using is the drop core, right? Now, so student, it is very clear that we can say that the drop core is used to make a hole in the casting either above or below the parting line. So same is the question here. When a hole or a cavity to be cored is not in a line with the parting surface, means here, not on the parting line, but in this case it is below, but maybe above also, but not exactly on the parting line. And that's why our answer is a drop core. Next question. Dash core is used when a casting does not want a through cavity. So in this diagram also you can see there is no through cavity has been generated in this case. So in such cases, we know that the balance core is used to create a hollow cavity in the casting that will be left free standing in the cavity of the mold blocks. Or I can say, in other words, it is placed within a parting line but does not extend all the way to the other side of the sand mold. So you can see here in this diagram, and from that I can say that a balance core is used when casting does not want a through cavity. Okay, means we can produce a blind hole. It is called as blind hole. In that case, we have to take the help of this balance core. Our next question. In three boxes molding, the middle box is known as. Now, when the pattern is of flange type, then it is not possible to produce in a two-box molding because it is not convenient. Okay, so in such cases, what we are doing, we know that there is a topmost is called as a cope, lowermost part is called as a drag, and the middle box, if you see in this diagram, is called as a check. And that's why our answer is C, check. Okay, so the middle box is called as a check. Next question. Why should the molding sand be porous? So in this case, the molding sand is the one in which the sand is known to have holes in it. And it is known for holding some amount of moisture content. A molding sand should be having porous and should be permeable so that the gases have a free path for escaping. And that's why I can say that our answer in this case is for gases to escape. So why should the molding sand be porous? Because we have to escape the gases. And that's our answer is B. Next question is, the sand in its natural or a moist state is called as a green sand actually. Green sand is not green in color, but green in the sense that is used in a wet state. So green sand is a mixture of silica sand, clay and water. And that's why our answer is A, green sand. Our next question is, which of the following is not a characteristics property of any molding sand? So I shown that through this diagram. This is the what we are showing, the flowability of the sand. Here also I am trying to show you the strength. The strength may be green strength or a dry strength. Because all these are the properties of the sand. But hardability is not a property of sand. And that's why answer is B. For next question, permeability can be defined as the property of molding sand. If you see in this diagram also, this video you can see here, why the permeability can be defined as a property of the molding sand? That is a question. So in such cases, we allow the gases to escape easily from the mold so that in the casting will not generate a blow holes. And that's why our answer is to allow the gases to escape easily from the mold. Our next question is, in what is the amount of clay needed in the green sand? So here in the green sand, the amount of clay needed in terms of percentage composition is approximately is between 15 to 30%, and the percentage of water is somewhere around 5%, and that's why our answer is C, 15 to 30%. Our next question, the function of the core in casting is two. So here also a core is a device used in casting and molding process to produce internal cavities. They are most commonly used in the sand casting. So here I can say that the function of the core in the casting to produce an internal cavity, we can see from this diagram also. It may be create a horizontal cavity or a vertical cavity also. Our next question is, which of the following is not a type of core according to their position? See, in this case, if I show you, this is a horizontal core, okay? Then there is a vertical core. Even I'm showing the one more core, which is called as a balance core. All these are the type of core, but inclined core is not a type of core. And that's why our answer is C, incline. The next question, which of the following is not true about the core chaplet used in the casting? So actually, I can say that the chaplet is actually a small metal inserts or a spacer used in the molding to provide the location. It also prevent the shifting of this core, and is also helpful to give the extra support to the core, which is shown in this diagram. These are the chaplets. Okay. So it may be in the pipe form. Okay. It may be in the, I can say, in the form of inserts. Okay. It may be in the form of spacers. Right. So it will ultimately, our answer in this case, it is removed after casting, is actually the wrong answer. And all about three are the right answers, because it is very clear that we can locate the position of this core, even we can prevent the shifting of this core. Also, we can give the extra support, okay, with the help of different type of chaplets. Here it is shown with the I section. It is also a pipe, or it is just like a spacers here, right? And that's why in this case, your answer is it is removed after casting. So your question is, which of the following is not true? So this statement is not true. Next is the ability of the molding sand to withstand the heat of melt without showing any sign of a softening is called. So generally what happens in this case, if answer is actually the refractoriness, because the refractoriness of the molding material is defined as the ability of a material to withstand at a high temperature of the molten metal. So the refractoriness are produced from natural and the synthetic material. And that's why our answer is B, refractiveness. Our next question is, the property of a sand due to which it involves a great amount of steam and other gases is called. Actually, in this case, your answer is the permeability. It is the property of a sand which permits the steam and other gases to pass through the sand depending upon the grain size, right? Even on the grain shape, moisture, and the clay component of the molding sand. If the sand is too fine, in that case, there is a low permeability. If the sand is too big, in that case, I can say it is having a high permeability. So that's why our answer is B. Next question. Large and heavy castings are made by. So here also, the answer is actually the green and sand molding. This casting method is referred to as a green, since the sand is recyclable and there are no chemical additives in this sand, just clay, water and sand. So the green sand, after water has been mixed into it, must have adequate strength and plasticity for making and handling of the mold. And that's why we can say that large and heavy castings are made by green sand molding. Next question. Which of the following is not a type of molding sand? So even if you see from these diagrams, it is very clear that the natural sand, okay, even the loam sand or synthetic sands are the type of molding sand which can be effectively used for casting process. But the red sand is not counted among the molding sand. And that's why our answer is red sand in this case. So thank you, friends.